how many people comes to me for a consultation thinking on very big numbers for taxes, yeah. and to see their smile after yeah. we make the forecast and they don't have to pay taxes or they pay very little. Yeah.
So you might also have heard that the taxes in Colombia are crazy if you're an expat. The top tax bracket is 39%, and yeah, maybe that's kind of discouraged you to live in Colombia. But how is it actually? We're gonna find that out in this video today with a tax accountant that works with expats since years and years, and this is where we're gonna go now.
So yeah, this is Paula Cruz. We finally made it, an interview with her. She's one of the tax accountant for expats here in Medellin, and we're gonna ask her some questions today. So maybe just quickly, can you explain what's the difference between somebody that doesn't have to file or pay tax and when are you a tax resident?
Bueno, let's say that the good thing in Colombia is that not everybody should file taxes, only people that has two tests. The first test is definitely we need to understand if somebody is a tax resident. Mm-hmm. And in this moment, it doesn't matter the citizenship, if yeah. it's Colombian, if it's a foreigner, if it has a visa. Mm-hmm. It's just if physically you stay in Colombia more than 183 days yeah. in a year, you will be a tax resident. Mm-hmm. If that will be the only filter for filing taxes, mm-hmm. we would be 50 million people filing taxes. Yeah. And no, in Colombia, only 4 million people file taxes.
That's crazy.
And that means it's because we have a second filter, a second mm-hmm. test. And the second test is, who must file taxes in Colombia? Somebody that is a tax resident and makes income, has income mm-hmm. in a year for more than 50 million pesos, mm-hmm. Colombian pesos. Somebody that has assets in all the world, mm-hmm. Colombia or abroad, for more than 150 million pesos. Mm-hmm. So when I'm talking about assets, I'm saying properties, investments, mm-hmm. money in the bank, mm-hmm. vehicles. Mm-hmm. Or somebody that has Colombian banks mm-hmm. and has transactions on that bank mm-hmm. for more than 50 million pesos in a year. Mm-hmm. So even when the tops look very low, yeah. that maybe people can reach them, no, only 4 million people can yeah. has the obligation to file taxes because get one of those stops.
Yeah, okay. So it's pretty much first you have to find out if you're a tax or a tax resident, right? Mm-hmm. And then you have to find out if you fall under the second filter, which is yeah, bank account, assets, income, and things like that. Usually expats reach that or no?
Yes, and it's because the currency.
Yeah.
Because many of the expats are making the money or are making income in US dollars, in euros, mm-hmm. in Canadian dollars. Yeah. So when you transfer that to Colombian pesos, looks very
yeah.
high.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. But yeah, Colombia has different tax brackets, right? From zero to how many
yes.
percent?
So in this moment, let's say that there is one tax rate for non-resident,
uh-huh.
35%.
Yeah.
Yes. For any taxable income, that will be.
Yeah.
But for residents, there are many different brackets.
Yeah.
And by other hand, we have different categories. For mm-hmm. them, one thing, one bracket is if you are an employee mm-hmm. or if you are an independent contractor working mm-hmm. always for the same company from mm-hmm. home or something like that. Another thing, if you are an investor, if you mm-hmm. are just getting dividends or if you yeah. are just getting rental income and you don't work, let's
yeah.
say. That is what we call capital investors.
Yeah, exactly.
So there are different brackets for those yeah. categories. But we have a very super good bracket from zero uh-huh. to more or less 36, 40 million pesos
yeah.
on taxable income, that is with bracket zero, with
yeah.
tax rate zero.
So that's around
then,
15,000 US dollars,
yes.
right? Which is 0% tax
yes.
if you gain that. Yeah.
And then we have progressive brackets, but the highest bracket is 35%.
Yeah.
So just on the last level, mm-hmm. for residents, we are on the same tax rate than non-residents,
yeah.
but we have progressive.
Yeah.
So
okay.
always it's possible to work and to prepare a good tax strategy,
yeah.
taking advantage of these brackets yeah. and of these categories.
Yeah. Okay. So you already see it gets already a very technical and complicated. So then the question would be, if I'm a normal expat, right? I'm a retiree, so I'm not, but if I would be a retiree, I may have a house in the US, something like that. Of course, maybe they already know that worldwide income is taxed, but what about retirement?
Private pensions, or even social security, or in this moment we have a legislation that says that it's exempt of taxes if fills some requirements.
Okay.
Of course, we have to check them. But in general, we can say that the pension is exempt of taxes, and there is a top, there is a limit. In this moment, it's 360 million Colombian pesos.
Yeah, that's around 100,000 US dollars, right?
100,000,
a little bit more, yeah.
So if you make more than that, you will be taxable on that amount over that. But if you are lower, no.
Okay.
In Colombia, in this moment, only maybe politicians, so very big CEOs have that kind of pension. So that is why for people, it's general to hear or to say pension are exempt of taxes.
Okay.
But the same is happening with foreign pensions. The thing would be different if you have a lot of assets.
Yeah.
So you will be taxed on your assets, but not on the pension.
Okay. So with your experience with most clients you have, like most people will get $3,000 to maybe $6,000 a month and maybe have a house in the US. Do they pay a lot of taxes, like more than $1,000, $2,000 a year?
That is a, let's say that the good thing of my job is that how many people comes to me for a consultation thinking on very big numbers for taxes and to see their smile at first. We make the forecast and they don't have to pay taxes or they pay very little. What you say, maybe sometimes it's less than $1,000. And so people say, oh no, nothing. Or sometimes when it's a little bit more, they just make the comparison. How much costs for me to avoid to be a tax resident? So being traveling all the time, just 6 months in Colombia, or just to pay that tax.
Exactly.
So sometimes people say, oh, it works. It works to live in Colombia, to pay that tax. And also, because in many countries, when you are filing already taxes, like in the US, they accept your tax credit for taxes paid in Colombia.
Even though you don't have a tax treaty between the two countries.
Yes, that is like an implicit agreement between countries.
Okay.
They call it collaborators countries, where if you pay taxes in one, the other one will accept that tax credit. Of course, each country has like a limit or requirements, but most of the time you can discount the taxes paid.
So at the end of the day, you would say for most people that are not like really rich CEOs or anything like that that come to Colombia, it's usually, they pay less than maybe $1,000, $2,000 a year in taxes, and that the whole thing is really, it looks way, way worse on paper than what it actually is in the real world. Would you agree?
Okay. Yes, definitely, definitely. And even many times, people is obligated to file just because they got these tops, the bank accounts, the income, but not pay. So that is why even on my speech or in my conversation, I like to focus on the word filing taxes instead of paying taxes. Because as I was explaining, from 4 million people that is filing taxes, 1 million people is paying taxes.
Of the 50 million residents in Colombia,
So most of the taxes in Colombia are in charge of the companies. But yes, so that is why I really like to say you will have to file and let's see if there is something to pay.
Okay. So I hope this helps. So if you want to contact Paula Cruz, the link to her company and contact details is in the link in the description down below. Thanks a lot for taking your time to answer those questions. I hope the whole misconception about taxes and how bad it is in Colombia is now a little bit more resolved, and you can watch into the future if you're thinking about relocating to Colombia without having that kind of in your mind and thinking it's a big deal and it's a big drawback of living in Colombia.